One thing I wanted to go over here is that whenever you put a controller into a coordinated system that does not have any interconnectivity, meaning there's no fiber or twisted pair or radio link, any way to communicate between the signals down a corridor, you have to make sure that your time of day or your time in your controller is set with all the other ones so that they stay in sync. So I'm going to check the time base and view the current. Now, I don't have the time up here right now, but this is the incorrect time. It shows 11:20. It's actually closer to 10:50, which means this particular signal in this run is going to be completely off from all the others. So what we want to do here is go in there and set the time to the correct time. Now, if one of the little apps that I use or something that I look at online is called Time.io, and I could put that in here, but I use that for always making sure that all my times are correct. And it says here that the time is actually 10:54. It even gives me the seconds too, so I'm gonna make it enter. And now we will be coordinated with all the other signals downstream. So that was a quick little video there, guys. You know, the takeaway there is I wanna show the importance of having your time of day set in your controller accurately, especially if it's in a coordinated run. You know, your coordination is gonna really be based off one, a great timing plan, and two, your time of day settings in the controller set accurately. So, you know, on a coordinated run, all controllers downstream are all based off this reference point. So if this controller down here has an offset 20 seconds later than this reference point, but it's off 10 seconds, well, your starter green is gonna be off and it's gonna just mess with the whole run. If you have questions or comments, leave them below. You know, you guys are the content creators. I will dictate my, you know, future videos based on what you said. See you next time.